Watch out, traveler. The veil's rips open and Maker knows what could come out.
Was that?
We don't know what these rifts can do. That one appeared to alter the time around it.
There are many mages in Redcliff. Maybe Fiona will know what's going on.
Maker, have mercy. It's over. Open the gates.
We spread word the Inquisition was coming. But you should know that no one here was expecting us.
No one? Not even Grand Enchanter Fiona?
If she was, she hasn't told anyone. We've arranged use of the tavern for the negotiations.
Agents of the Inquisition, my apologies. Magister Alexius is in charge now, but hasn't yet arrived. He's expected shortly. You can speak with the former Grand Enchanter in the meantime.
The veil is weaker here than in Haven. And not merely weak, but altered in a way I have not seen.
We should talk to the Grand Enchanter.
Ratcliffe when the dead walked into our village. We will not flee now. Attacking anyone they think might be aiding the rebel mages.
Welcome, agents of the Inquisition. What has brought you to Redcliffe?
We're here because of your invitation back in Val Royeaux.
You must be mistaken. I haven't been to Val Royeaux since before the Conclave.
If it wasn't you who invited me here, who was it?
I don't know. Now that you say it, I feel strange. Whoever or whatever brought you here, the situation has changed. The Free Mages have already pledged themselves to the service of the Tevinter Imperium.
An alliance with Tevinter? Do you not fear all of Thedas turning against you?
Andraste's ass. I'm trying to think of a single worse thing you've done, and I've got nothing, nothing.
I understand that you are afraid, but you deserve better than slavery.
I no longer have the authority to negotiate with you.
The Divine's corpse is barely cold, and you've already joined the Imperium?
Most of Thedas blames us for the Divine's death. The Templar attacks grew worse, and we mages had no allies. Either my people made a last stand here in Redcliffe, or we took the only offer of help extended to us. I had to save them. I had no other choice.
Welcome, my friends. I apologize for not greeting you earlier.
Agents of the Inquisition. Allow me to introduce Magister Geryon Alexius.
The Southern Mages are under my command. And you are the survivor, yes? The one from the Fade? Interesting.
If you're leading the Mages now, then let's talk. I'm sure we can come to an arrangement.
It is always a pleasure to meet a reasonable woman. Felix, would you send for a scribe, please? Pardon my manners. My son Felix, friends. I am not surprised you're here. Containing the breach is not a feat that many could even attempt. There is no telling how many mages would be needed for such an endeavor. Ambitious, indeed.
Does that mean you'll lend your mages to our cause?
There will have to be.
I'm so sorry. Please forgive my clumsiness, my lady.
Are you all right?
I'm fine, Father.
Come, I'll get your powders. Please excuse me, friends. We will have to continue this another time. Fiona, I require your assistance back at the castle.
I don't mean to trouble everyone.
I shall send word to the Inquisition. We will conclude this business at a later date.
come to the Chantry, you are in danger.
Ooh, very mysterious.
We'll be careful, but we need to figure out what's going on here.
Last night.
No, there'll be no talk of this.
It was so real. And when I woke up, the sheets were as cold as ice. I talked to one of the rebel mages. She said it sounded like a dream she had.
Now help me close this, would you? How does that work exactly? You don't even know, do you? You just wiggle your fingers and boom, rift closes.
Who are you?
Ah, getting ahead of myself again, I see. Dorian of House Parvus, most recently of Minrathus. How do you do?
Another Tevinta. Be cautious with this one.
Suspicious friends you have here. Magister Alexius was once my mentor. So my assistance should be valuable, as I'm sure you can imagine.
You're betraying your mentor because...
Alexius was my mentor, meaning he's not any longer, not for some time. Look, you must know there's danger. That should be obvious even without the note. Let's start with Alexius claiming the allegiance of the mage rebels out from under you. As if by magic, yes? Which is exactly right. To reach Redcliffe, before the Inquisition, Alexius distorted time itself.
He arranged it so he could arrive here just after the Divine died?
You catch on quick.
That is fascinating, if true, and almost certainly dangerous.
The rift you closed here. You saw how it twisted time around itself, sped some things up and slowed others down. Soon, there will be more like it. And they'll appear further and further away from Redcliffe. The magic Alexius is using is wildly unstable, and it's unraveling the world.
I'd like more proof than magical time control. Go with it.
I know what I'm talking about. I helped develop this magic. When I was still his apprentice, it was pure theory. Alexius could never get it to work. What I don't understand is why he's doing it. Ripping time to shreds just to gain a few hundred lackeys?
He didn't do it for them.
Took you long enough. Is he getting suspicious?
No, but I shouldn't have played the illness card. I thought he'd be fussing over me all day. My father's joined a cult, Tevinter Supremacists. They call themselves Venatori. And I can tell you one thing. Whatever he's done for them, he's done it to get to you.
All this for me. And I didn't get Alexius anything.
Send him a fruit basket. Everyone loves those. You know you're his target. Expecting the trap is the first step in turning it to your advantage. I can't stay in Redcliffe. Alexius doesn't know I'm here, and I want to keep it that way for now. But whenever you're ready to deal with him, I want to be there. I'll be in touch. Oh, and Felix, try not to get yourself killed.
There are worse things than dying, Dorian.
This whole business is...
Whoa.
Thank you.
We could make camp here.
Nothing to report, sir.